I knew I wanted to meet Billy more or less straight away, and obviously your emotions are a very potent mixture of grief and loss and anger. And one of the things that made me really angry was that although Billy straight away had admitted throwing the punch, he had pleaded self-defence. And I was very angry at that because I knew that, and anybody who knew Adam would know that he would have never threatened or made anybody afraid. That wasn't what he did. He'd never been involved in anything like that in his life. And I wanted to confront Billy with this. And I wanted to be in the same room as him. I wanted him to have to look into my eyes and tell me, in his own words, what happened. So that was the start of it. And I let the police liaison officers know what I wanted with it. I can't remember the exact date, but very soon again. And they were a bit surprised because although they were familiar with restorative justice, they weren't familiar with the idea of it being used in a crime this serious. But they supported me and started looking into the possibilities. The next thing that happened was the trial. Nothing had developed before that. And at the trial, this feeling of needing to see Billy intensified because he showed no remorse. I had to confront him, and he had to know the damage he'd done by the way he'd acted that night. He started his sentence and nothing really changed. What changed for me was that we were no longer being looked after by the police liaison officers. We were handed over, as it were, to the probation service victim support. They went along with the idea that this should happen and they would find ways of doing it. And again, nothing happened until at the end of his first year in prison, he was moved to another institution. And then things did change, because he attended a victim awareness course and it had a big impact on him. He told his offender manager that he wanted to see me. And this was a big step forward. I felt much more optimistic about the outcome. So it eventually took place 2 years after Adam died. And at the meeting itself, the first thing Billy did was apologise. Now that, on its own, was an important thing for me. But there were still these other things that I wanted to sort with him. And I challenged him about Adam threatening him. And straight away he said, Adam didn't threaten me. Well, I wanted to hear that. I knew it was true and I knew that was the fact. But to hear him say it was very important. And I still felt it important to get across to him the damage, the hurt that he'd caused. And I didn't really hold back on that. And I took virtually the script of Adam's story. I went through with him, including the quotations from his friends, particularly Rachel, and that those had a big impact on him, and the whole meeting got very emotional. I think he'd managed to prepare himself for the idea that that of what he'd done to us, Pat and I, but it hadn't dawned on him how much the damage had spread, if you like, and the fact that his friends were so affected really got to him. When he told me that Adam hadn't threatened him, I asked him, what was Adam saying to you? And he couldn't tell me because he was too drunk to remember. He wanted to tell me, but he couldn't. He hadn't a clue. And that was disappointing. But overall, it was a very, very positive and satisfactory meeting because it did a great deal to get rid of the remnants of the anger. That the anger had declined over the couple of years. It's bound to, but it was still there. But that meeting really helped to put that to rest. Didn't do anything to help the grief and the sense of loss. That was a different dimension, if you like. But it did help with the anger. Although the restorative justice is mainly for the benefit of the victim, to give the victim a voice of some kind in the procedure, it also can have a spin-off that benefits the offender and the offender's chance of rehabilitation. Because if you've been able to say you're sorry and you've accepted full responsibility for what's happened, and you're in a far better position to get on positively with the rest of your life.